you keep it like that, the cream is still warm, so you're going to have some condensation, and after all the water from the condensation going down, okay? And it will affect the texture. So I'm just going to put it like that. Because once the cream will be cold, it will be very easy to remove. Huh? Very, very easy. So just like that. So we're just going to keep it in the fridge. So it's a small quantity, so after 30 minutes it will be done. But to pipe easily, because if you take off your cream from the fridge and you try to pipe, impossible to warm. Okay, so you can keep it for 1 or 2 hours, or even the day before you make it, you keep it in the fridge. And after you leave it at room temperature for maybe 1 or 2 hours, because this one, we make it yesterday, it's the one we used this morning. And I keep it at room temperature, and you will see it's very soft, and it will be very, very easy to pipe. So far no question for the shell. Everybody can do. Sure. No, if it's too watery, that's why the best, when you pour the last part of the powder, mix very slowly first, you stop and you see the texture. It's better to have it a little bit hard, more hard than too liquid, because when it's too liquid, after the macaron is going to be out of shape, and when you bake it, sometimes also you will see, because it, and this morning it's happened, sometimes when the mix is too liquid, the macaron stays very soft on the middle, and you cannot get something very very nice.
So you add more
Because after you change the texture of the recipe. That's why it's the most tricky part, is the last part of the powder. You put it slowly and you mix slowly to make sure. When you see the mix start to fall down like that, you stop. Because once you start to pipe, you continue to push on the mix, so the mix become also soft. Okay? So that they start to be... So I put the oven first at 180, because once you, for example, you will see later on everybody going to pipe, so for almost 1 hour all the oven going to be full of macaron. So on the recipe is right at 150 degrees, but always when you make a cake, you if your recipe for example is right at 150, you put the temperature at 160-165. Okay, a little bit more hot, because once you open, so you have some cold air going inside, and you put 1 or 2 tray cold, the temperature will go down. So if I put my oven at 150, I put 3 tray inside, the temperature will go down until maybe 110 degrees. So if your oven is at 110 degrees, the macaron is not going to rise properly. Okay, and that one is for any type of a recipe you make for sponge. For example, if you make one sponge, you need to put the oven a little bit more hot. But of course, you need to change the recipe. Because if you don't do it like us, when we bake macaron at Canley, it's 40 tray, one shot. So it's around 3,000 shell, one recipe. So sometimes my staff forget to put back the temperature, so after you have 3,000 shell burn. So, which happens sometimes. So like you can see, inside the oven, they start to rise. So for the professional oven, what we have at work, we have a special touch where all the condensation can come out, which in those kind of oven, you don't have it. So what is good to do is inside, in 1 or 2 minutes, you just open a little bit the door to let the humidity and the condensation out. Like that, the shell will be dry. It's better to bake a little bit more your shell than to have it underbaked, because if it's underbaked, you will not be able to use it, because first it's going to stick to paper and the top will be soft, so even after you keep it in the fridge, it will be even softer, and when you eat your macaron, it will be very solid, and you will not have the texture, okay, because when macaron is all about texture, So even if you bake it a little bit more, it's not a problem because the later stage when I'm going to put the chocolate cream is the most important. Because once you put your cream, you cannot eat the macaron directly. You need to leave the macaron a certain time to leave it rest and all the flavor combined together. Because if you want, you put your chocolate cream between your two shells. So you leave it first in the fridge, and all the humidity of the cream will affect the shell, and is where you're going to have the nice texture. So that's why the top need to be hard, because normally when macaron you bite into, you have first the shell, the crispiness of the shell, and after you have the chewiness of the garnish. So it's the most important, because you have two parts. You can, I will explain to you later on, you can freeze the macaron or you can leave it for a certain amount of hours in the fridge before to eat. For example, the macaron that I'm making now, it will be ready only tomorrow if you keep it in the fridge, because you need to leave it for 12 hours in the fridge minimum before to eat. Okay, to have a certain amount of time to have the nice texture inside. And of course, when you make some homemade macaron, sometimes you buy some macaron, you leave it in the fridge and you eat right away, and it's very hard. Because you need to leave it outside before to eat one macaron, you need to leave it outside for maybe 30 minutes, 45 minutes to let the cream come back at the right the right texture. You can take off the chocolate cream on this moment, please. So now I'm going to open just a little bit. They're nice. So you will see this oven, all these parts bake way stronger than the other one. So you see, the cream is very hard. So if you try to eat that, one macaron like that, from the fridge, impossible to work. So you need to leave it, because this texture, now one is outside, and you can see this texture, I can press, it's very smooth. So I'm going to switch the tray, so you can see the shell are nice. So I just switch it. And the one with the nuts also. Three minutes is it's okay. So how to see that when macaron is baked, I will show you. You're going to press the top, and if you see the macaron doesn't move, meaning the fruit is ready, it's enough hard. And after we will check under to see if he's not too wet. So just nice. Take a little bit of chocolate cream. So far no question for the chef. Everybody can bite. Yes, yeah. You put it back if the recipe is right on one.